Before we look at coding in the NVivo program, we're going to very briefly look at some theory behind coding. Coding is an essential part of virtually every qualitative study, as it helps researchers to make sense of unstructured data. By unstructured data, we can see some examples on the slide here. From photography and videos, to interviews and literature, all of these are good examples of unstructured data. As a process, coding is about mining your data. What you're looking for will depend on your project, but it could include attitudes, behaviours, activities, strategies, concepts, meanings, participation, actions, behaviour, language, sentiment, ideas, themes, and a whole range of other stuff depending on your research methodology. As part of coding, you need to label snippets of your data. These snippets are called codes. So, if we take an example from Barbara's interview, it's a case of you as a researcher looking at some of that text and thinking how you're going to label it. And with NVivo, we can look at one idea, such as local community, and see where it occurs in different files, coding across images, video, textual files, and datasets. And of course, you continue to do this for any other codes that you have, layering up your data with rich levels of information. As you can see, this is a very messy process, and this is where NVivo and other software can help. But before we look at how to do this in vivo, a little bit more theory. Codes are not identified or discovered. They are created by you, the researcher. So, where one researcher looks and sees local community, another might label it differently, such as community identity. The precise way in which you will code is defined by your epistemology, your methodological approach, and your analytical choices. If you're studying at the University of Hull, you'll find access to SAGE research methods is a valuable way for you to navigate some of these complicated concepts. When you are working with text, you can code a single word, a phrase, a sentence, a paragraph, or a whole source. And this really impacts how you later are able to interpret your data. Again, this can link very much to your methodological approach. This also works with any other form of data, whether it's a dataset, video or audio, or images. You can code as small or as large a piece of that data as required for your code and to help with your analysis. There are generally two types of code, grounded or a priori. Grounded codes emerge from the data. You put aside your assumptions and see what you find. With a priori codes, however, you've previously identified some things that you're looking for. These could be based on literature, or on some initial assumptions. There are many ways in which you can identify potential themes and codes. You can look for the repetition of words, look at how keywords appear in context. You may identify them through comparison of different sources, by looking at what isn't said, by looking for metaphors and analogy, looking at transitions, connections, and uncoded text. The next video will start to look at how we mechanically code in NVivo, but hopefully this video has given you a much better idea of what coding is and what we mean by a code. Before coding in NVivo, it's really important that you're confident with what approach you're using, so it's always useful to hammer that out as part of your research plan and have those discussions with research supervisors and colleagues.